can sample the water until it's the right temperature.
Exactly.
Okay? So you open the valve and then put your hand over to the left or to the right into the water. So that, you know, no one likes having to turn the valves on and be right underneath the shower head when that blast of cold comes out. So there you go. All right, we got many, many more questions to answer. I'm going to do it as soon as we come back. I'm so glad you joined me this morning. So much more to come. You're home with Dean Sharp and Health Whisperer on AM.
This great enough for radio station
after
hours. Scary.
Bad passenger.
Go.
Four-size bag.
People's food disappears from the refrigerator. It's a nightmare.
KOSP-HD2.
Los Angeles, Orange County.
Live everywhere on the Air Radio app. Trick or treat. I'm Brian Berman, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. The LAPD is urging parents to keep their kids safe from street racing over the holiday weekend. Officer Brian Wendling says the warning for parents spans across the entire SoCal region.
It's not just LA area, it's not just California area. This is a national. We just have the best weather in the nation, and so they do it year round here.
He says holiday behavior falls on a Sunday, which is the one day out of the week when street racing is
happening.
Any indication, you see a bunch of vehicles gathering and you hear vehicle engines revving, that's probably a good time to stop and get your kids to safety.
When he says racing is not only dangerous for the drivers, but also spectators. Blake Trolley, KFI News.
News brought to you by Leader Hero. A new study by Kaiser says parents are more likely to give their kids the COVID vaccine after some contact. The FDA has authorized the Pfizer vaccine for kids 5 to 11. This mom says she's ready to give it to her kid, especially since other vaccines are already required for school.
She's actually due for her last round of vaccinations for, like, MMR, mumps, measles, rubella, like, next month. So, I mean, I think that it's easy to just lock COVID into the same thing.
Responses from the Kaiser Family Foundation survey say 26% of people said they will give their child the vaccine right away, and less than a third say they will not give the vaccine to their kids. A portion of the A and E Metro rail lines will be closed through Sunday as crews do construction on the regional connector transit project. The closure will repeat during the weekends of November 12th and December 10th. Metro bus line E69 will replace train service at the stations, and Metro buses are temporarily free to ride due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Metro is also going to provide staff at the train platforms to guide riders to the nearest bus. The Port of L.A. has a plan to clear an estimated 40% of the cargo that's been sitting around waiting to be picked up.
A $100 dwell fee will be charged per container per day starting Monday. For each truck-bound container sitting more than 9 days, that increases $100 each day, potentially costing shippers millions every day.
I hope the program is resoundingly unsuccessful. Because if we don't collect the money, that means the cargo is moving.
Port of L.A. Executive Director Dean Soroka says because of this, companies that weren't speaking up to help fix the supply chain crisis are now looking for solutions.
We need to get products to market for the holidays, to our hospitals, and to our factories throughout the country.
In L.A., Corbin Carson, KFI News.
Former President Trump says President Biden is not securing America's borders.
When you look at what they're doing at the border, there's never been anything like it. The greatest we've ever had went to the worst, probably one of the worst in the history of the world.
Trump says if he were in charge, he'd stop the millions of people crossing the border into the U.S. He said Mexico was giving the U.S. 28,000 troops for border security for free before Biden took office. And he says the border wall would have been finished if he was president. Parents in Los Alamitos have planned a protest for Monday to demand the resignation of school board president Marlise Davidson. Davidson was heard on a microphone making comments about parents who were saying they didn't want their kids to get the COVID-19 vaccine at a meeting on Tuesday. This parent tells the John and Ken show there's no coming back from this.
She showed her true color. She made more than one comment on that Tuesday, so it wasn't just an accident. She kept saying people make mistakes. Her supporters are saying she makes mistakes, people make mistakes. She did it several times that evening, and it's just inexcusable. She has to leave.
Davidson has apologized for making those comments. And we are going back to that crash on the 5.
In Laguna Hills, southbound side of the 5 before Alicia Parkway. It's actually a couple of crashes, it looks like. One in the right lane, one in the carpool lane. Overall, delays start at Lake Forest Drive. Costa Mesa 405 southbound Harbor to Bristol. Caltrans still taking up four right lanes there. They should be in the process of wrapping up this closure, but really heavy delay starting at Euclid. Fontana, northbound 15 from Sierra Avenue to the 215. It's two right lanes coming up around 10 o'clock this morning. And Ontario, westbound side of the 10, Haven to 4th Street. Four right lanes out of commission until Monday morning. That sets you back up to Milliken. KFI and his guy have kicked there faster. I'm Robert DeBucky.
When it comes to your identity and keeping it safe, the folks at LifeLock want to make sure that your information stays secure. So let's say during the pandemic, or even now, you're working overtime, you're saving your money, you're paying off your debt, and now some identity thief wants to steal your information. This is why LifeLock by Norton helps monitor your information and alerts you to potential identity threats. And if you do become a victim, a dedicated U.S.-based specialist will be there to help fix it. Now, no one can prevent all identity theft from monitoring every transaction, every business. But when identity thieves try to take what's yours, you don't have to take it lying down because there's LifeLock. Save up to 25% off your first year. Call 800-LIFELOCK. Or go to LifeLock.com, promo code handle. That's LifeLock.com, promo code handle. Or call 800-LIFELOCK, promo code handle. Once again, that's promo code handle for 25% off at LifeLock.com.
Stuff on weather from KFI. Heavy fog this morning. Fog advisory from the LA and OC coast into further inland until 9. This morning, sunny skies by the afternoon, mid-60s to low-70s at the beaches, mid-60s to mid-70s in metro LA and OC, partly cloudy in the inland valleys with highs in the mid-70s to low-80s, upper-70s to low-80s in the inland empire. Right now it's 55 degrees in Brea, 57 in San Clemente, 59 in Culver City, and 55 in Pasadena. We lead local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Brian Bruner. Wow, they just keep going, don't they? They're just going. Sitting in their kitchen, they're just going. Custom home builder, custom home designer, that's what I am. Here with you live like I am every weekend. Saturdays from 6 to 8, Sundays from 9 to 11. It is just a little after 7 o'clock, so welcome to the second hour of our time program. What are we all about? We're here to help. To be an advocate for you as you wrestle with construction issues, to be a design mentor, because design matters most when it comes to transforming your home, and just to be a friend, helping you build yourself a more beautiful home, a more beautiful life, and do it more affordably and more artfully than you ever imagined. We are in the middle of answering a very special list, what we call common listener questions. Not just the occasional question, no, we get these again and again. These are kind of pervasive questions that we get asked on a regular basis. So we thought, you know what, let's kind of show aside and answer a few of them. So, with that, without any further ado, let's go back to Tina. What do we got next?
How can you tell if I have a plumbing leak? That's a common one for us, especially with copper failing.
True. So the easiest way to figure out that you have a plumbing leak is to suspect. Now, obviously, if there's a wet spot on the floor or the wall or the ceiling, you may have a plumbing leak. But I think the real
thing. People get a letter from the water company and they'll say, you know, we've noticed that you had this large amount of water more than normal for the last 24 hours.
Okay. So, and if you get a letter like that from the water company, the first culprit usually to look at is to go out and activate your sprinkler.
Activate your sprinkler system, run through all the circuits on your sprinkler system. Because what I have found the most common thing is sprinklers are going off, nobody's paying attention to them. Hopefully, in Southern California, your sprinklers are set to go off at nighttime, not during the day. But then again, when that happens, you're not really paying attention to them. And if you have lost a sprinkler head, you know, you may have a geyser out there, you may be consuming a lot of water out of that system, way more than you normally would. It doesn't mean you have a leak. It just means that you're blowing the water unnecessarily through an open sprinkler line while the sprinklers are running. Okay, so putting that aside and any other sign of a visible leak, there's actually a really easy way to tell. And it has been provided to you by the company that made your water meter. So first of all, know where your water meter is. Your mom's water meter is out on the edge of your property, out in front, near the street. It's very likely in the parking lot, in between the sidewalk and the curb, if you have a park there. The water meter's got a cover on it. That cover can be lifted off super easy. If it's a little bit, you know, junk in there with mud or whatever, then take out a screwdriver, bring a long screwdriver with you and put it in the hole and kind of pry it out. But the cover will come off. Be careful reaching down inside there because it's the kind of place that is damp and covered up most of the time. And so, you know, creepy crawlers like to hide out in there. There's probably some snails in there or maybe a black widow spider. So just be careful about that. But you will find underneath that cover your water meter. And on top of your water meter is a little cap that covers up the dial. Flip up that cap and you will find the dial. It looks like an odometer on your car. And because it is sitting there measuring the amount of gallons of water you are consuming that the water company is going to charge you for. Right on that dial, ignore the big numbers on the odometer. Look for a tiny little sign. Sometimes it's a triangle. Sometimes it's star shape. Sometimes it's a funky other shape. But it's a tiny little dial indicator. It's either black or red or yellow. And if you are not sure, if you think you're looking at it, but you're not sure, the best way to tell is to have somebody turn on some water inside the house, flip on a faucet and stuff. That little dial is the infinitesimal water leakage dial. In other words, that tiny little dial, if any of water at all, is moving through the water meter, that dial will tell. They turn slowly and they turn fast. That is your leak indicator sign. So, if you suspect you might have a leak, or somebody has put it in your head that you might have a leak, then simply make sure no water is being consumed anywhere on the property. All faucets are off. The dishwasher isn't running. The laundry isn't going. There's no demand whatsoever. Go after the water meter. Turn it on. Open it up, look at the dial, and if that little indicator is not moving, you do not have a leak in your system. If it is moving, then somewhere water is being consumed. And then the next step is to figure out where. And usually, unfortunately, when there is a leak that you cannot see moisture on walls or ceilings or anything like that, especially in an older home in Southern California, there's a good chance it's happening in flat. And so, if you are convinced you have a leak, you call out a leak detection service. They'll scan the flat, try and find the accumulated water underneath, and then you have to deal with it from there. It may be time to abandon the copper pipes that are down below the flat and repipe those supply lines overhead. But that is how it's done. Okay. Really good question. I know you got a ton more. We'll dive back in with Tina's question. Well, they aren't Tina's questions, but she's reading them. As we return, I'm so glad you joined me this morning. So much more to come. You're listening to Home, the Beans at the House Whisper. Let's hear the news. I'm Brian Brennan, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. UFC has admitted to knowing about reports of assault and drugging at school frat parties weeks before students were told. The number of people in the hospital with COVID in Riverside County is up from earlier in the week, as those numbers are dropping in L.A. and Orange County. And a person has been killed in a crash early this morning at the Lincoln Avenue off-ramp on the 57th Freeway in Anaheim. And we're looking at some trouble on the 15th. That's You've been lied to. Lied to by corrupt Washington politicians and the Wall Street propaganda machine. Hi, I'm Inc. Magazine best-selling author Jeff Kitchen, and I want to give you a free copy of my brand new book, Wealthy on Wall Street, because we all know another market crash could be right around the corner. After losing 35% in my IRA in the crash years ago, I said enough, and since then I discovered a way to grow money potentially double digits, reduce taxes dramatically, and also have my money protected when the next stock market crash hits. When the next market crash hits, you lose nothing. Call Wealthy on Wall Street now to get your free copy and talk with a specialist to discover this little-known strategy to get potential double-digit growth during good years and never lose when the next stock market crash hits, all while building a tax-advantaged retirement. Call 800-908-1616 to discover this asset that people like Walt Disney and JCPenney use to grow wealthy. Plus, get one of just 97 free books left. We even cover shipping and handling, no credit card required. Call 800-908-1616. That's 800-908-1616. 1-800-908-1616. We're looking at some roadwork on the 15th.
On the northbound side of the 15th here, out into the 215, the southbound is just a few right lanes shut down. Until around 10 o'clock this morning, you are seeing pretty heavy slowdown in that area there. In Moreno Valley on the 215 northbound, the connection to the 15 east, the Moreno Valley is approaching the 15th. It is shut down until around 4 o'clock this afternoon. You're seeing all along the main line of the 215 starting around Eucalyptus. And we still have this crash working in Laguna Hills on the southbound side of the 5 before Olisa Parkway. The right lane taken away there, you're getting back to Lake Forest Drive. KFI is a dial-up to get faster.
But this is one sponsored by Lowe's. During Lowe's Pro-Member event, new members of their Pro-Loyalty program get a welcome kit via mail. And every member gets a chance to win an amazing prize. Pro-Member, now through November 24th. Lowe's, the new home for pros.
Hey, it's Dean Sharp. So, what did you do during the last power outage?
My guess is not much.
Yeah, nothing disrupts your life, your comfort, even your safety, like a power outage. And the power companies have spoken. Outages are the new normal. So here's my advice. Set up your home with a permanent emergency generator from my friends at Duffy Power, and it never has to happen again. Duffy is Southern California's generator expert. KFI trusts Duffy with our generators, and so should you. And with 0% interest financing and payments as low as $72 a month, your emergency power is totally affordable. From the largest commercial systems to your unique home, Duffy Power will make sure your life, your comfort, and your safety won't be interrupted during the next outage or all the ones after that. Dial #250 on your cell and say Duffy Power. #250, Duffy Power. Or find Duffy on the web at DuffyPower.com. That's DuffyPower.com.
This report is sponsored by Lowe's. Are you putting your retirement savings in a 401k or IRA? Then I have one word of advice. Stop. Experts agree the 401k has been a dismal failure. And even the man who invented it now says it's a monster that could be destroyed. 401ks and IRAs have major danger, including fees that gobble up 50% of your retirement savings over time. The government controls your money and changes the rules anytime they want. And it gets worse. History confirms we're past due for a major market crash that could wipe out 50% of your savings again. Now, a free report from Bank on Yourself reveals where the inventor of the 401k put his money. You're 100% protected from crashes. There are no fee surprises. And you control your money, not the government. Plus, your withdrawals are tax-free, which protects your savings from being devoured by taxes that can only get more monstrous. So get your report now at freereportfast.com. That's freereportfast.com. Freereportfast.com.
This is Liz.
Oh, hi, Mom.
She just stepped up to care for her mom. And she has questions. Lots of questions. Liz, meet CareWell. It's your shop for caregiving and medical supplies. Get brands like Depends, Ensure, and Tranquility delivered at prices you'll love from 24/7 care specialists trained to take your questions and super fast shipping. Caregiving isn't easy, but you don't have to do it alone. Visit carewell.com/radio for $10 off. That's carewell.com/radio. Terms apply.
What's all the buzz about nasal irrigation and Navage, and should I try it? Here's the science. Airborne germs invade through your nose. It's the body's air filter for trapping allergens and viruses. When your nose gets clogged, it's less effective and germs multiply. Eventually, your immune system can get overwhelmed and you get sick. Nasal irrigation is an effective, all-natural way to clean your nose. It's not a drug. It's more like plumbing. Saline goes in one nostril, around the back of the nose, and out the other nostril.
flushing out mucus and germs. I'm Martin Hope, and I invented Navage to make cleaning your nose easy. It's the world's only nose cleaner with powered suction. Navage pulls out the bad stuff so you can breathe better, sleep deeper, snore less, and feel healthier. At Walgreens, CVS, Rite Aid, Target, Bed Bath, and Walmart. Or go to Navage.com for a free gift with purchase. Over 2 million sold. Navage, N-A-V-A-G-E. Clean nose, healthy life.
Hey, I'm billion-dollar broker Ryan Serhant, and I'm here to tell you that my very, very popular and successful podcast, Big Money Energy, is returning for Season 2 on October 25th, so subscribe now. Season 2 features conversations with some of the smartest people in the world, like Neil deGrasse Tyson, Ben Baller, Rebecca Minkoff, Jenny Slice, and more. Listen to Big Money Energy on the iHeartRadio app, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you get your podcasts.
How long I'll be at this job. I know it's been 30 years at KFI, but you never know. One day the teacher says, you know, Neil, it's either you lose weight or we have to widen the doors. We might have to part ways.
The Fork Report with Neil Saavedra.
Or they could say, you know what? You're just too handsome. That's probably the way to go.
This afternoon at 2 on KFI AM 640.
More stimulating talk.
Whisper at your service. I'm so glad you joined me this morning. Hey, I would love to talk to you about what's going on with your home today. So coming up in a few minutes, we may go back to the phone. So now's your chance. The phone lines are open. You can give me a call. Jump into the queue. The number to reach me at, 833-2-ASK-DEAN. 833-2-ASK-DEAN. Talk to Misty. She'll treat you right, and then you and I, we can talk about what's going on with your home. Until then, we are right in the middle of a little show we call Common Listener Questions, where Tina is basically has compiled a list of the kind of questions that we hear again and again and again and again, and so they make it into kind of this elite list. So without any further ado, Tina, fire away.
Okay, so the next one I think is a good one, too. Why do I need that ugly air gap from a dishwasher?
Oh, the air gap. The air gap. Why do you need it? Why do any of us need it? As a builder, I don't care, okay? It's just a necessary evil. As a designer, I care a lot. We try and get air gap hidden or tucked away or, you know. All right, so the air gap, that's that little cylindrical thing. It's usually covered with a stainless, what looks like a stainless steel or a chrome cap, sitting right next to your kitchen faucet on the edge of your sink, and it gurgles when your dishwasher drains. So here's the thing. The whole point of the air gap is very simply this, to provide a distance between the water that is draining out of the dishwasher and any sewage backups or issues that may take place inside the sewer line. The reason is because what if, for some reason your sewer lines, your drain lines back up? What if they get clogged? And what if that backup starts rising up in the pipes all the way into, let's say, your kitchen sink, okay? Now, if it happens in your kitchen sink, you can get to it. You can clean it out and, sanitize it later. But your dishwasher is connected to drain into the P-trap area just below your kitchen sink. So that backup also then would lead into the dishwasher drain line and down into the sensitive parts of your dishwasher. In other words, sewage inside your dishwasher, which is never a good idea as far as dissipating or now circulating that contaminated water onto all your dishes. So, therefore, the air gap. What the air gap does, what you can't see, is literally what it says. It is a gap. The line is broken with an airspace so that if the sewer backed up, what would happen is it would overflow the sink and you would see it coming out of that air gap area, but it would come out there and not proceed down into the discharge line of the dishwasher. It has to be high up. In fact, it has to be up above the highest receptacle of water in the area, which is the sink. That's why it has to sit up above the sink level, because it's higher than the actual maximum level of water that the sink can hold. There are and have been many ways of trying to resolve it. We can eliminate an air gap with what we call a high loop up underneath the countertop. Talk to 10 plumbers, you're going to get 10 different opinions about whether the high loop is a good idea or not. Right now, all I can tell you, in the state of California and in Southern California municipalities, air gaps are required. There's just no way around it, so position it in the most attractive way possible and deal with it. And I can tell you this, of all the other creative solutions, the air gap is still the most efficient and best device in regards to protecting your dishwasher. We don't want it to be a mechanical device, because mechanical devices can fail. Mm-hmm. So it is a non-mechanical device that just sits there. It'll never fail because it doesn't have to move. It just does what it does. All right, there you go. Next.
Okay. Kind of in the water category. Does a tankless water heater give you instant hot water?
No, it does not. That's another confusing thing. Tankless water heaters, you hear them advertised all the time. Tankless hot water, you know, it's a whole new way of having hot water. That's true. What a tankless water heater does is it gives you endless hot water, not instant hot water, okay? Endless hot water means that there's no tank on the tankless water heater, and when it's sized properly for your home, it will simply keep cranking out hot water. Cold water enters one side, it goes through an elaborate coil system with a lot of flame against that coil, and by the time it reaches the other side of the water heater, it is at hot temperature, which means that you can take a two-hour shower, and then I can take a two-hour shower, and then somebody else can take a two-hour shower. Why is there a third person in our house, Tina, taking a two-hour shower? I do not know, but they can, and they will stay in our house because the hot water won't run out. However, when the hot water in your home is not being used, it sits in the pipe. And as it sits in the pipe between the water heater and the faucet, it's going to cool off, right? This is the classic, turn on the faucet, you don't have instant hot water, we all sit there and we let the water run for a minute until it starts to heat up. That is purging off that cooled off water until the new hot water reaches the faucet, okay? The only way to avoid that is to A, repipe your house so that your hot water is on a circulating system. That means that not only do hot water lines run to your faucet location, but there's a hot water line that runs away from it back to the heater, and then there's a recirculating pump that keeps the hot water moving in the lines all the time, and thereby, every time you turn on the water, the hot is right there, okay? The other solution is to put what we call an instant hot device underneath the sink that preheats the first minute or so of water electrically underneath the sink until the actual hot water shows up. And the third way to do it, which has become a part of code now, is you can put a small recirculating pump at the point of use underneath the sink in the vanity.
Because
the recirculating pump bleeds water off the hot water line and pushes it into the cold.